Hey everyone, Jeff here from TheRevitKid.com. This year for my yearly review and setup for 2019, I decided to make a video instead of writing a big long blog post. And so first and foremost, I want to say happy holidays and happy new year to the Revit Kid community. So usually what I do for my yearly reviews is I'll talk about sort of what went well during 2018, some of the new things that happened, and then some of the plans I have for 2019. So I figured we'd run through a couple different things. So first and foremost, let's talk about the blog. For those of you that don't know, I run a blog called TheRevitKid.com. On that blog, there's a bunch of free video tutorials, tips, tricks, and information, as well as some premium content when it comes to Autodesk Revit and all things really BIM related. This year, the blog had approximately 356,000 unique visits, which means 356,000 unique individuals came to the site, which is pretty sweet. But what's even cooler is out of that 360, 160,000 of them were brand new. So 160,000 new people. So maybe you out there, maybe discovered me this year, which is awesome, visited the blog, which is really cool. But even more exciting than the actual stats of visits to the blog is the fact that this year, in 2019, in February to be exact, TheRevitKid.com will turn exactly 10 years old. My very first post, believe it or not, was 10 years ago from February of this year. So February 2009 was my very first post. So be sure to keep an eye on the blog because I'm planning on doing some fun stuff for the 10-year anniversary of TheRevitKid.com. Some of the more popular posts this year, I'd like to highlight a couple of those. They actually had a lot in relation with each other, which is pretty cool. The first one has to do with lines and silhouettes. And so this was the number three most visited blog post of this year. All the links to these blog posts will be down below in the comments or in the post. And what's kind of funny is the number three and the number two visited this year are very similar. The number two was actually a post from directly extracted from one of my premium content courses called Volume 1. And the post had to do with creating big diagrams, so Bjork Engel style diagrams in Revit. So again, if you're interested in that video or that post, check out the link below. Finally, the most popular post of this year, and I'm using popularity as simply the amount of unique visits to that particular post, had to do with Lumion. So it was my From Revit to Lumion review of Lumion 8.0 Pro. And so this is my third review of Lumion. I think I started in six, I started reviewing in six. So six, seven, and eight, this was number three. And I am actually planning on a review post for Lumion 9.0, which I started using back in the beginning of November when it came out. Some really, really good stuff happening in 9 and some not so good stuff that I'm hoping maybe they fix in a couple patches, but some really, really good improvements. So keep an eye out early this year, as in early 2019. For the Lumion 9 review. So beyond just the blog at TheRevitKid.com, I also sell premium courses under the BIM After Dark banner. And so BIM After Dark is, there's right now there's four courses. There's Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3, and DIY Dynamo. So this year I was pretty excited. I re-released, and so completely made from scratch. Volume 1, which was 5 years old at the time, and extremely valuable stuff. It has to do with presentation topics in Revit, so creating renderings, floor plans, diagrams, you name it, you go down the list. That's what Volume 1 encompasses. But this year I completely made it from the remade it from the ground up, because a lot of the content was a little outdated and some of my techniques have changed over the last 5 years. So that course relaunched in August of this year. And I'm excited to announce that this year alone, BIM After Dark in all four courses, we gained 253 new students, which is awesome. I'm very humbled by the fact that you guys find the content that I create valuable enough to even pay me some money to use it, which is awesome. So look for some new enrollments for things like DIY Dynamo, which is a beginning course in Dynamo, as well as Volume 1, Volume 2, and Volume 3. One of the things I did this year as well when it comes to some of these courses and some of the content is I did hold a lot of workshops towards the end of the year. So these were free workshops that it was pretty much just me sitting at the computer and showing you some really cool stuff, some kind of presentation, usually on a specific topic. Those are pretty popular. The first one I did I think there's over 600 people online live, and the second one was about 1,000 people. And then I did a couple Dynamo ones towards the end of the year, which were a few hundred people on those. So they were extremely popular. I got great feedback from you guys. So this year, in 2019, I plan on doing a lot more workshops. So make sure you sign up for my email list. You can find that at the blog or the link below to get more information on that, as well as here on the YouTube channel. Speaking of YouTube, this year I started focusing a little more on YouTube, and in 2019, I plan on focusing a lot on YouTube, mainly because I've spoken to a lot of the readers, a lot of people watching this channel, and many of you discover my website and my videos through YouTube just by searching, you know, how do I create topography in Revit, or how do I make lights turn on in a rendering in Revit, whatever. I'm sure there's a video that maybe got you to where my website is, and so I want to thank you for that, first of all. I also want to remind people to subscribe to my YouTube channel. We're actually at 18,000, let me look, 18,570 subscribers today as I record this, and I gained over 6,000 subscribers this year, which is pretty awesome. One little tip for those of you who maybe aren't subscribed but maybe follow the blog is that I do have some content on YouTube that isn't on the blog, but I also tutorial videos usually end up going live on YouTube before the blog post is finished. So a little pro tip: if you follow me on YouTube, you may actually see the tutorial video before it even goes on the blog. Finally, this year I did attend one conference. I made it a little last. I think 2017. I think I attended like 5 conferences. It was a little much. It took quite a bit of time, as you can imagine, and quite a bit of effort when you're speaking at some of those conferences. This year, I attended one conference. It was the Built North America Conference. There's a post about it, which I'll link below. It was a great conference. I really enjoyed it. My presentation went over really well, which is cool. It had to do with making construction sexy, so really using presentation techniques from architecture and using them during construction. So it was really valuable. And for those of you who I ran into at Built and we chatted, great to see you. Thanks for hanging out. And last but certainly not least, 2018, I became a father. So my son Jacob was born. Hey everyone, I'd like you to meet Jacob Adam, my son. He just kind of woke up, so he's a little out of it. Say hello to the Revit Kid world, buddy. Say hi. He's really excited to meet you, I promise. Super excited. So far, I'm really enjoying it, and I hope you guys get to see a little more of Jacob as he grows. So in conclusion, 2018 was a great year. I had a good time. I think there's a lot of cool things that happened on the blog. I want to thank you all for following me. I'm not sure if you can see, but on the board behind me, I have a whole bunch of list of to-do elements for 2019. So that's the plan. And 2019 is going to bring a lot more workshops. There's going to be some sort of an event in February to celebrate 10 freaking years, go figure. And I'm going to try my best, even with a newborn child in the home, to continue posting regularly. I've got a whole list of tutorial videos and questions that people have asked me that I just need to bang out and create the post and throw them out there. So keep an eye on all the content. Everyone have a fantastic new year and a great holiday. And I'll see you all in 2019.